Hello children, good afternoon. How are all of you? Hope you had gone through the bomb. Anyway, we are still on that review, that is why no video has been newly sent. So we just go through the bomb once again. And in this bomb, you need not learn the entire bomb. We learn the bomb only on page number 27. Now how much I am going to read, that so much only you got to learn. And also the words which I am going to say, please underline those words and write them at least 10 times in your notebook. Okay, notebook means in your rough notebook. So first I just read through the poem. Please listen carefully. It's about a fairy. A fairy, she goes marketing. First she buy a bird, a fish. A fish, and she put it in a crystal bowl. Crystal bowl means the glass which is of good quality, it is called crystal. And she put the fish in the crystal bowl, and the crystal bowl is placed on a golden dish. After that she goes and buy a colored bird, the very colorful bird she goes and buy. And she was sitting in wonderment and listening to the bird singing. After some time she opened the cage and let the bird go. Let the bird free to move around. And then what happened? And what kind of a song she sang? She sang the, yes, very sweet, shrill song. Okay, then let's start reading. Fine. A fairy went a marketing. She bought a little fish. She went marketing and she bought a little fish. She put it in a crystal bowl upon a golden dish. She sat in wonderment, and means one hour, and here they are because the word sounds as, what is it? Yes, it is the sound of O sound, R sound. So that is the vowel sound, that is why we are using an R. Okay, it is not a vowel word, but here the pronunciation is a vowel sound, that is why we are using an R. An R, she sat in wonderment and watched its silver gleam. She was sitting in front of the, front of the crystal bowl, and she was watching it. And that fish, as it was moving, it had a silver gleam, that line, silver line. And then she gently took it up. Gently means very slowly she took it up and slipped it into the stream where the water was running down, which is flowing. She put it into that stream. That's the first 8 lines. Okay, so learn thoroughly. Thoroughly means perfectly you must learn. Properly you must learn. A fairy went marketing. Again she went marketing. She bought a colored fish. Beautiful, colorful bird, sorry, colorful bird she bought. It sang the sweetest shrill song, that very thin way of singing. She sang the sweetest shrill song that ever she had heard. She has never heard such a beautiful song. So the bird was singing, such a thin voice she was singing, and it was sounding very beautiful. She sat beside its painted cage. She sat beside means at the side of the cage which is painted. She sat beside that, at the side of it, and listened half the way, half the day, not half the way, half day. She was sitting and listening to that. And then she opened wide the door and let it fly away. After all that, she opened the door and she let the bird fly away and be free. So, dear children, please learn this poem on page number 27. Now I'm going to give you some words which you listen to it and underline in your book, and then write it 10 times in your notebook. Notebook means your rough notebook, not in your English notebook. Fairy, underline fairy. Marketing, bought. Crystal bowl, golden dish. H-O-U-R, wonderment, watched, gleam, gently, stream, colored, shrilled, sweetest, bought, beside, painted, listened, white, opened, all these words, please write them at least 10 times. Okay. Now we are moving on to, you just got to read the next one. You don't have to by heart it, because you should know the words used in this and the word meanings in it. Okay. So now we are going to move on to the lesson, value of time. What do you mean by value of time? Time is very precious. The time what is there before you, you should use the time in the proper way. Utilize the time in the proper way. There's a time to study, there's a time to wake up, time to pray, time to play. So everything is got a time. So do that at the correct time. Because the time which is past, which is gone, you cannot bring back those times. So there is a time to study, there is a time to sleep, there is a time to eat. For everything there is a time. So what you understand from this is, you have to sort out your time. You have to schedule your time. You have to make a timetable for yourself. So you will find time for everything. To study, to play, to sleep, everything. You must make your own timetable. So take page number 30, page number 30. We are only going through the word meanings today. We are not going to the lesson because I have not started the lesson. Even school, I have not started. Because we are on a thorough review now. Whatever the lesson which is taken, I am just recalling all that, giving dictations and test papers. So those are sitting at home, please learn the poem thoroughly. Now the entire poem I told you just now, only that 16 lines. Okay. Alright. Now take page number 30. Value of time. So you must know how to schedule your time. Activities. See, once the lesson is taken, teachers give you homework or some assignments. That is called activity actual. Things that are done keeping something in mind. Now, activity means what you do. You plan yourself and do things. That is a kind of activity. Activities, things that are done keeping something in mind. Next one, assignments. Now, assignments. Now, teachers take lesson in the class and then on the lesson, based on the lesson, ask you to do something based on the lesson. Sometimes it may be to find question answers or to make a diagram. It is something like that, that is called an assignment. Work that is given as part of studies, that is called assignment. Attempt, to make an effort to do something. You are trying to do something, whether it goes bad or good, you are making an attempt, you are just trying. Attention, an act of listening or doing something carefully. Every time when the teachers are taking class, yes, you have to be attentive in the class. You pay attention to understand what the teacher is explaining or what the teacher is telling you or asking you. Bloom, to become fully open. Fully open means flowers. They flower. Sometimes, some season, the trees will completely bloom, full of flowers. It opens up fully. To be full grown, there are two meanings for that, to be fully open or to be full grown. Collecting, bringing things together, many things together you bring to one place and keep it, many packets together you collect. Sometimes you collect money and then yes, at the end of the year you open it and you do something which you want to buy, you do collect money and then buy things. That is collecting. Disturb, to interrupt somebody when she or he is trying to work or do something. Disturbing somebody means that not allowing them to do what they are doing. So it may cause disturbance. Foolish, not showing good sense, not wise. Sometimes we all of us, not only you or not only me, sometimes we do sometimes some foolish things. Sometimes which we don't have to say, we say. So that is called foolish. memorize. Learn carefully so that it can be remembered. You especially learn, yes, learn the poem to memorize. You read many times. That is to memorize, to keep in your mind. Mumbling, speak or saying something in a way that is not clear. You will be talking but you may not understand, or sometimes it may not be clear, or the words will not come out from your mouth. That is mumbling. Recitation competition. Recitation competition means a poem which has been said before a judge or a person. There will be many people who will present the same thing or maybe some other poem, and who says it best, they get the reward. They get the award or reward, whatever. So that is competition. Recitation means the poem that is called recitation, to say the poem. Recitation competition. Competition means just you are presenting yourself, whatever you know. Sometimes you may get, however you present, maybe better than you, somebody presents, the person who presents properly will get the prize. So till there you please learn, okay, recitation competition. So much of meaning which I have taken just now, you please learn that. So the next class I will be taking the lesson. I have not taken here also, so you don't get worried. Learn the poem thoroughly, okay, right? See you in the next class.